Good evening, everyone. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for being here tonight. You know what? I'm going to sit down. All right. I usually don't do that, but it's been a long day. You guys pray for me. It's been a long day. And I'm sure it's been a long day for a lot of you, too. But you're about to be blessed tonight. And you're going to be uplifted. And if you're tired when you came in, you won't be tired when you leave. Because what you hear tonight, these kids have worked hard. Your children have worked hard. The teachers have worked hard. This is our first through fifth grade. And for some of these students, it's the first time, well, they were here at Christmas. This will be the second time that they perform. Here at Central Fellowship, we like to start our students off on recorders. They learn the rhythms, they learn the notes, they learn the fingerings. And then hopefully what we pray for is once they're done with recorders, they'll want to go ahead and go to instruments. And we have two wonderful teachers. We have Miss Melody McPherson. You pray for her. She's about to pop. And we appreciate you good folks working with us. We did move this thing up a week early. And we appreciate you bearing with us and doing that because next week, Lord willing, there'll be a newborn here in Central Fellowship Christian Academy. So you be praying for Miss McPherson while she's up there. I said, don't get excited. I don't want any excitement like that going on tonight. So be praying for her. We also have Miss Shirley Monk, our band director, and a very, very talented lady. And she works with the recorders. And what we hope then will be that your students, or our students, your children, will build up to instruments. There's nothing like fine arts, folks. We love athletics. I did both when I was growing up. And no matter how old we get, believe it or not, I'm almost, I'm not going to tell you, 28 and holding. I am now taking piano lessons. So, my mom wanted me to do it when I was very little. Of course, I was rebellious. And I played everything else, but now I'm back on the piano. It's never too late. As long as the Lord's got your mind going and you can hook it up to your fingers, you can play the piano. So anybody out there, find a good piano teacher, and it's something you can do all of your life. And that's, we hope we get your children off to a good start here. Okay? I'm getting ready to finish up here, get out of these folks' way. By the way, I'm Jim Keels. I'm the fine arts director here for the school. And on behalf of Pastor Rodney Queen and Pastor Josh Queen, we welcome you. And again, we're glad you're here. We're gonna do something a little different this year. I know a lot of you already know about the Teacher Appreciation Week. It starts next week, but since we're here now, we're not going to pass anything around. We'll remind everybody at the end of, end of the program, we'll have two gentlemen at the exits. If you'd like to go ahead and contribute now to the Teacher Appreciation Week, they'll have a bowl, just put the money in there, we'll make sure it gets to the right place. If you're not ready to do it tonight, just go ahead and do it next week, okay? All right. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you for this night. We thank you for allowing us to be here, Lord. We just ask now for your protection around this facility. Everybody that is here, Lord, may you just cover us with your feathers, with your wings. Keep us safe tonight. May it be a great evening in you. May you be glorified by everything that is done tonight, Lord. And Lord, may we just leave here rejoicing and praising you for a wonderful evening. Lord, we thank you for these children. We know they're a gift from you. And Lord, we don't take it lightly that the parents have come and entrusted us with caring for their kids here at the school. And Lord, may we just do what is right in your eyes and proper and true and honest and holy and praiseworthy. Lord, we thank you. Yes. Thank you, Lord. And it's in your Son Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Ladies and gentlemen, kids under construction, reporters, elementary band, and choir.
going to have a debut on the bass drum. For a good bass drum.
Oats and beans and barley. I outside reporter Monica Fisher.
Thanks, Simon. As you can see, I stay outside the new Site Community Church, where a ceremony to dedicate this new building is getting ready to start. While the dignitaries, which include our mayor, councilman, and our very own woman, Sunshine, are gathering for this occasion, I have here Mr. Joe Carpenter of Carpenter Construction Companies. Mr. Carpenter, this must have been a huge contract for you. How did this all happen?
Well, Monica, I've been in this business for many a year, but I have to say this project was my absolute favorite.
Why is that, Mr. Carpenter?
You see, I've been a member of this congregation for a long time. We have grew our first building and had nowhere to expand, so the church bought this prime property.
Say, didn't this land just have a factory located on it?
Yes, in fact, it was a total mess. We had to tear down the entire thing before we could build it right.
Monica, we have some footage of that. I believe I covered that story 6 months ago.
Yes, I believe you did, Simon.
Back when I had your job and you had mine. Not that you were bitter or anything.
Yes, Simon, I did have to adjust my attitude a tad.
A tad? Whatever. Let's roll the footage. Let's roll the footage for our viewers. It was quite a demolition. I remember it like it was yesterday.
Yeah.
fun if they had.
Simon, my friend, you are on the air.
Oh, hello there. We just witnessed a fascinating demolition live. It was quite exhilarating to watch.
Good day. Simon, do you have the general contractor on site?
Yes, I have Frank Carpenter.
It's Joe Carpenter?
Yes, Joe. Now that you demolished the old building, what's next?
I'll let my project manager, Bobby, speak to that.
Hi. Well, the first thing we've got to do is to get a plan.
A plan? Like a blueprint?
Well, it's more than a blueprint. We have a master plan.
A master plan?
Yes, sir. We need to know exactly what we were building.
It's just like in life. We need to have a model so that we'll know what we want our lives to become.
Simon, what are they talking about? A model for one's life?
I'm not sure we're all following you. Can you explain this model for our viewers?
Absolutely.
The station will probably send me back out in 6 months to cover your progress. Probably when it's freezing and 10 below.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll look forward to seeing you again. God bless.
Ta-da! I've arrived again.
Well, Sasha, why are you here today?
Oh, Joe, you know I'm a decorator on this set. Why shouldn't I be here?
Well, we haven't even poured down the foundation yet. In fact, we have to level the land first. There's puddles and cracks everywhere.
Now, Joe, I could show you some shortcuts to make it look marvelous. Some putty here, some paint there. No one knows the difference. At Tadada Signs, our slogan is don't waste time or dime what the eye can't see.
Sasha, you know that's not the way we do things around here.
You can say that again.
Remember, there are two kinds of builders in this world.
In fact, let us tell you about these guys. Crew! What, crew, we talked about this, about our attitudes during the building process?
Yes, if we want God's blessings on our work, we've got to care about one another and even put their needs above our own. Now, it isn't always easy, but we must stick with it and persevere, because perseverance will produce
godly character.
Yes, remember what I said. Jesus gave us the Beatitudes so that we could check if we have
an attitude of gratitude.
I'm sorry, Taylor.
I am Sue Piper.
There you go. We want God's blessings in our lives and on this project.
Monica, but we're glad you're here.
Yeah, well, I was the lead anchor 5
sure you did. But Monica, believe me, these things have a way of working out. Just give it a little time.
Miss Monica, I like your pearl necklace. It's beautiful.
Well, it's a token gift for my booster after 5 years of hard work.
Well, I like it.
I like your bracelet, too. Is it made of gold?
Yes, it is. Can you say retail therapy?
Retail therapy!
Ma'am, I think my girl's hit on something.
What?
You know, some things might not be so pleasant at the time, but God can make something beautiful out of all kinds of situations, if you'll allow him to.
What do you mean?
Just think of what that oyster had to go through to make that beautiful pearl necklace you're wearing.
Huh? I never thought of it that way. Well, that was 100 years ago.
How about that?
Sasha, I never had a chance to say goodbye, and I'm sorry the studio cut your job.
Oh, honey, that's the best thing that ever happened to me. Because of that, I got the courage to start my own decorating business. It's called Ta-da!
Ta-da! What a perfect name. I'm so happy for you.
So when you lost your job, Sasha, God knew it would be a blessing in disguise?
You should say that again. It definitely was a blessing in disguise. When I lost my job, I thought God had forgotten all about me.
I know the feeling.
I knew God loved me and had a plan for my life.
So what did you do?
I prayed, Monica. I prayed.
Community Church is about to start.
Thanks, Simon. I'm thrilled to be here right now. I like to introduce you to my pastor.
Your pastor? Really, Monica? When did this happen?
This happened when I met some of the most marvelous people while covering the story. They introduced me to Jesus, and I figured out how to get a marvelous plan for my life. Oh, let's welcome Pastor Williams, who will lead us in the dedication this morning.
Our Father in heaven, it is with great joy that we gather to honor you this morning. May this be a place where we can glorify your holy name. May it always be a place where people may come to find new lives and through your Son, Jesus Christ, who dedicated to you. And all God's people say,
thank you.
Outstanding, guys. Outstanding. Well done. Please stand over there. Set this up. We have a lot of folks that help out. The teachers coordinate. They work well. I'd like to ask Mrs. Long and Miss Melanie if you can stand up carefully. Nothing happened, okay? We got something for you. Where we at? There you go. Let's give our directors a round of applause. Thank you for coming. I hope you were blessed by what you saw tonight. Yeah. And again, we want to thank you for coming. We're going to have Pastor Josh Queen, our school administrator, close us with prayer. Please, folks, stay a little bit, mingle if you like. But most of all, please be careful going home. Okay? Please be careful going home. Get a good night's rest in the Lord. New day tomorrow. Amen? All right. Let's pray.
Father in heaven, Lord, we are grateful for what we saw. Let's put on display tonight, Lord, all these things that were said, all the things that were sung. All this is done for your glory. Lord, I thank you for all the work that's gone into this, Lord. And again, thank you for the students and for the director for this show. A wonderful production, again, as we mentioned. Done for your glory. I pray that you will bless each family as they leave tonight. Again, Lord, we are thankful for what you've blessed us with. Whether it's the school, our families, your creation, the most important work of Jesus Christ, and what we've done in the cross. We pray these things in Jesus' name.